Hey Eagles, welcome to another edition of GCTV. I'm Jared Snort here with Daniel Crump.
The Batuga Suns Teen of the Week program features a different local student each week, selected from nominees submitted by high school guidance counselors throughout Western Kentucky and Southern Illinois.
Our very own Preston Simmons was chosen for this special honor. Preston received an article in the paper as well as $2,500 scholarship to the university of his choice. Now Preston tells us a little more.
Well, I was chosen as the Teen of the Week. I had to submit an application. I had to talk about my extracurriculars, all my awards and achievements. I had to do an interview. It's actually on the Paducah Sun website now. It feels really good to be Teen of the Week. I think I'm the first one from the school, so that's really neat. And I feel really honored to have been given this award.
Thanks, Preston, and congratulations once again.
This Friday, Mr. McMillan and Ms. Henderson will be in the Commons during lunch to help any students connecting their wireless devices to the internet. If you got a new device, may need help, or you've got any other questions, stop by the Commons and talk to them.
Don't forget to bring in your gently used and clean coats to your first period teacher by October 19th. The first period class that brings the most wins a buffet breakfast. Please be generous with your giving.
Credit recovery tutoring is available on Mondays and Thursdays after school until 5 p.m. in the LEED building.
Juniors, Balfour will be here again tomorrow during lunch from 5 to 8 p.m. to take orders for class rings. Seniors may also order during this time. Extra ring packets are in the front office. Please bring a minimum deposit when you order your ring.
The Red Cross blood drive is next Friday. Students 16 and older can give blood. Registration will be held in the Commons during lunches on Thursday and Friday of this week, as well as Monday and Tuesday of next week.
Our GCHS Lady Eagle Volleyball team will be having a fundraiser at Snappy Tomatoes from Friday from 5 to 9 p.m. The girls will be working as waitresses and accepting tips as donations. Come out and support the team. Coming up during the break, Colby Wilford gives us a sneak peek at a new horror movie, and Colton tells us about the dropping temperatures.
Hey GC, this is Warmfront, and it's time for your hump day weather forecast. Today we're going to have a high of about 62, becoming sunny, with a low of about 37. Thursday we're going to have a high of 66, with a low of 55, and about a 60% chance of showers. And on Friday, we're going to have a 30% chance of showers, with a high of 71 and a low of 56. This has been your GC weather.
Hey GC, welcome to another episode of Eagle Entertainment. Now, since it's the Halloween season, I decided, what better way to enjoy this frightful season than a good old horror movie?
Family found earlier this week.
I didn't want to move here.
We couldn't afford to live in the old house anymore. Plus, the new story I'm writing is here.
Is the story a good one this time?
I'm gonna write the best book that anybody's ever read. I got a really good feeling about this.
You gotta be kidding me. Family hanging out. Barbecue 79. That's the family who lived here.
Do you think these are serial murders?
I don't know. First one I found dates back to the 60s. The only link between all these cases is the symbol.
The symbol is associated with a pagan deity named Bagul. He consumes the souls of human children.
Sinister is a frightening new thriller from the producer of the Paranormal Activity films and the writer and director of The Exorcism of Emily Rose. Ethan Hawke plays a true crime novelist who discovers a box of mysterious, disturbing home movies that plunge his family into a nightmarish experience of supernatural horror. Sinister will be out in theaters this Friday, so grab a friend, an extra pair of underwear, and go see Sinister. For Eagle Entertainment, I'm Colby Wilford.
Yeah!
Nation, we had a pretty rough night last night in our sports action. To start off, our volleyball team lost in the third district championship to Ballard Memorial, losing one match to three matches. However, a big congratulations goes to Whitney Wiley, Tiffany Sanderson, and Caitlin Nisley for making the all-district volleyball team. Last night, Whitney had 20 assists, Tiffany had 26 digs, Caitlin had 9 kills and 2 blocks, and sophomore Tori Wiggins had 6 kills. But the Eagles suffered yet another loss last night as well. Our guys' soccer team played Marshall County for the district win, but fell short, losing 1-2. Coach Sims would like to thank all his senior boys for their hard work and dedication throughout the years. You made Grace County proud. But tonight we may have redemption against Marshall County. Our Lady Eagles soccer team faces off against the Marshalls tonight, 5 o'clock at the soccer field. Good luck, ladies. For GCTV Sports, I'm Tyler Adams.
Are you interested in joining the swim team? If so, bring your friends and talk to Mr. Mallory in room E25 sometime this week for more information.
If you're interested in the bowling team, their season is almost here. Any students interested should meet in the gym tomorrow during CCR time.
Students interested in walking wrestling should speak to Coach Gerard in the Commons during CCR time before Friday.
Tryouts for the boys' basketball team will be from 3:30 to 5 on October 15th and 16th. If you want to try out, you need to speak with Coach Birdsong before the tryouts. Students interested in participating in the Future Problem Solvers team should meet E25 after school on Monday, October 15th.
FBLA members, you will have a meeting tomorrow in the gym.
Interact Club, you will have a meeting tomorrow during upperclassmen break in room B17.
Key Club will have a meeting tomorrow in Miss Waldrop's room. You can still join, just bring a $5 fee.
Orchestra is now selling butter braids. Butter braids are $12 and you can purchase them from any orchestra member.
Seniors, vote for your favorite senior shirt design this week during lunch. Each vote costs 50 cents and all proceeds go to Relay for Life.
Also, seniors, if you're interested in applying for Rotary Student on the Month, please go to the school website to fill out an application. You'll need to email your application to Ms. Tilford by this Friday. Applications can also be picked up outside of Ms. Tilford's office.
Also, last minute reminder, Agape, this is the last day to turn in shirt orders, and Friday there's a meeting for all board members during CCR.
That's all for today's show. Have a great day, GC. Apple juice.